I am not the biggest fan of curls and crunches just because I believe there's a lot more productive things you can be doing for core. Crunches and sit-ups are not inherently bad exercises. I just believe there's more productive core exercises you can be doing. It's a better use of your time. However, some people that are dealing with a back injury may have a flexion intolerant back, meaning that they don't tolerate that repetitive bending forward, and they may need a modification. So what if you have this flexion intolerant back, but you're in a workout class where you don't want to be the oddball out doing something completely different? Here's a modification you can use so you don't look like that guy or that girl in the workout class. First, we'll start in a crunch-like position, and from here we want to make sure to flatten the spine, bring the belt buckle toward the nose. Once we're in position here, rather than bending and flexing forward a bunch from the low back here, what I want you to think about is there's a string attached to your chest to the ceiling. Now think of that string being pulled up toward the ceiling. Now I'm simply lifting here without bending down here, and I'm still getting the shakes, feeling that burn at the core. Now, a crucial tip here is a lot of people will want to turtle head this. They're going to lift and start straining their neck forward. Here's a key tip that can be difficult. You want to pull your chin in towards your throat, so you're pushing the back of your head into your fingers behind your head. I'm going to drop my elbow here for the sake of you seeing this. So keep that chin pulled in, and then now think about that string being pulled up toward the ceiling. Good. So now I'm getting that core burn, but at the same time, I'm not turtle heading it. I'm actually driving this force from my abs without overstraining my neck abs to get up there.